The following program is brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.
So Genesis 1:14 told us that God made lights and separated day from night and used the lights in this for signs and seasons and days and years. And then Genesis 1:15 says, and they will be in the sky. He put them in the sky to light the earth. And it happened. That's Genesis 1:15. Put the skies, the lights in the earth. And it's this beginning of a sign for all of us that we are to be the light of the world. We're to let our light shine. So let your light shine. Would this remind you of anything, like maybe Sunday school? This little light of mine, right? I'm going to let it shine. Say, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine said, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. Come on, church, let's let it shine. Roll it.
It's the Kevin Shorey Show. Taped before a live studio audience at the Branson Mill in Branson, Missouri. Today, Kevin's special guest, Tom Wilcox. Special music by Bethany Cottle. And now, the lights are on, so we know you're home. You better watch the Kevin Shorey Show. Here's your host, Kevin Shorey.
Bye-bye. Welcome to the Kevin Shorey Show. Isn't it a great day to serve the Lord? We're glad that you're watching right now. It's going to be a great program. For the first time on our program, singing a song about me and Jesus. You and Jesus. How many know you and Jesus are a majority? We win every time. I'm going to stick to the winner. Ladies and gentlemen, Bethany Cottle.
Me and Jesus got our own thing going. Me and Jesus got it all worked out. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. We don't need anybody, tells what's all about. I know a man once was a sinner. I know a man who once was drunk. I know a man, once was a loser. He went out one day and made an altar out of his stump. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. Me and Jesus got it all worked out. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. We don't need anybody, tells what's all about. Jesus brought me through all of my troubles. Jesus brought me through all of my trials. Jesus brought me through all of my heartaches. And I know that Jesus ain't gonna forsake me now. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. Me and Jesus got it all worked out. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. We don't need anybody, tells what's all about. We can't afford fancy preaching. No, we can't afford no fancy church. We can't afford any fancy singing. But you know Jesus got a lot of poor people out doing his work. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. Me and Jesus got it all worked out. Me and Jesus got our own thing going. We don't need anybody, tells what it's all about. No, we don't need anybody, tells what it's all about. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, Bethany. She's coming back to sing another song. Bible says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 17, comfort your hearts and be established in every good word and work. When I think of establishing in every good word and work, I think of this next pastor. I'm so honored that he is here today. Every good work, I hear nothing but good from First Presbyterian here in Branson, Missouri. Here is Pastor Tom Wilcox. Would you welcome
him? Hey, Kevin.
And I mean it from all my heart. Your reputation precedes you. My wife, she loves you, and in a good way, because her ministry that she runs, the Caring People, the very first in Branson, was at your church. Thank you, sir.
Yep. And we love having her there.
Yeah, and thank you so much for that. My wife runs a ministry for single moms, in case y'all don't know, so appreciate that. But every time we hear of something that's new and happening in ministry in town, we hear it's coming from First Presbyterian. How long have you been pastoring there?
About 6.5 years.
Wow. Really a short time, but yet so much accomplished, and new things are happening. Tell us what's happening with the church, and then we'll get into the Bible in a little bit here. But
one of the big things we're working on is learning how to be missional.
Mm-hmm.
The church, especially in the 20th century, got really good at being invitational, saying, hey, folks, come on in. We've got some great things we want to do to bless you.
Right.
And you try to have a great church facility and great church programs, but the generations today aren't necessarily comfortable being in church.
Right.
And so you can build it, doesn't necessarily mean they'll come.
They'll come. That was the mantra for a while.
It was.
Like Field of Dreams. You build the church, they'll come. Not so much anymore.
So
that's so
missional
wise,
is different from invitational in that invitational is y'all come into where we are so we can bless you.
Yeah.
Missional is we're going to go out and live out Christ's love where you're doing life.
Amen, amen.
And so it's getting out of the church, into the community, and
And isn't that more Christ's biblical?
Love.
Isn't that what
it
Jesus
is.
Said? To go.
It's what he did.
He didn't say, let them come. He says, go.
Yeah, it's
into
what he
the
did.
World. And that's what you're doing. And how are you implementing that in some of the ways that you're just sending?
We're trying to understand better and better the community around us,
yeah.
the needs in the community, how we can love on them, ways that we can become a missional presence. For me, in order to practice what I'm preaching, I've become the chaplain for the Branson Police Department.
Oh, congratulations. Yeah. Isn't that great?
It is.
Yeah. And had they had a chaplain before? Or?
They had some care given by Captain Steve Lisby.
Mm-hmm.
Who would be the third highest ranked officer in the police department. But they found it wasn't an ideal fit, that having somebody who was in command over you being
right.
the chaplain was a conflict.
Yeah.
And so that didn't last.
They had a captive audience anyway.
That's
they had
right.
to go, but
he's also kind of IA for the department, so you might be a little careful about confessing things to him.
That's right. Yeah, that's kind of a mixed message. Internal
and
affairs.
He's an amazing believer. He's a great guy, and I know he loved on the people really well.
Sure.
But they did find the conflict was not great. And it's a new administration under Chief Dobbins that has energized this interest in this type of care
this
for the police
officers. This is great. I think they found the right man for the job,
so I'm excited about it.
That
I love him.
It is exciting. I'm so thankful that they do that. There's no place like Branson, I tell you. We brag about Branson all the time, but I think the whole world should live here, but I'm glad they don't. But I mean,
the whole world should visit.
They should visit Branson for sure. And so, you know, we've been talking the past week or two, actually 2 weeks now, since the shooting in Texas, in the middle of a Sunday. A Sunday morning service, everyone blown away and killed or wounded severely. You know, when stuff like that happens, obviously, what we're doing, and I think you're on the right track being missional in this way and going out. Because, you know, the build it, they'll come kind of deal. Well, now where they build it and the shooters come. I mean, evil is all around us. But if we can make an impact outside of the walls, you know, that will affect every part of society. What's your belief on that? I mean,
we have to be light in a dark world.
Yeah.
But the world's going to be dark until Jesus comes back.
Yeah.
And so sin exists. People do terrible things, sinful, evil things. And that was both sinful and evil.
Totally.
You know, a broken person, we don't know, I don't know his story. I don't know how he got broken. I know Jesus loved him, and it breaks God's heart to see anyone as dysfunctional as that.
Well, wouldn't you think it's a symptom of the whole nation? We really are sick right now, and we really need a healing.
We do.
And we have the answer. You know, and it starts with us. It really does.
It does.
It really does. We can blame this or that. Oh, well, it's the liberals, or it's the, you know, it's the atheists, or it's, you know, whatever community. But it starts with us.
Yeah.
From Chronicles 7, when it says, if my people will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from our wicked
ways.
Right. Right? I'm preaching, but you're supposed to be the preacher, so.
You're doing a great job.
Well, thank you, and I'm glad that you're rallying the troops there at your church as well, and all of our churches together. We're part of the body of Christ that lift up Jesus.
Yeah.
You know, and God said, if they're not, you know, they're not against me, they're for me, and we're all together.
Well, and we can't stop doing that out of fear.
Right.
You know, being a believer has never been safe. Out of the original apostles, John's the only one who died of old age.
Yeah.
The rest of them were all martyred for their faith.
Yeah.
So being a believer has never been safe.
No.
And that's people say, you know, how can you believe in God when something like this happens? How can you not depend on God when things like this happen?
What's the truth? I don't know how folks survive in different things when tragedy hit my home. I mean, if it wasn't for the Lord, you know, my mom died in a terrible freak accident. If it had not been for the Lord,
yeah,
I don't know where I'd been. And where were you originally from, born and raised? Are you a Ozarkian?
No, a little bit all over this country, but mainly in the Northeast originally.
Northeast.
My dad worked for GE, and they moved him 9 to 18 months when I was little.
Oh,
so
okay.
We were in, by the time I was 11, I'd been in 5 states and in 8 different homes.
Wow, it sounds like my life for a
moving.
Whole different reason. Yeah, I was born in Massachusetts, and by way of Florida, came here.
There you go.
And met my wonderful wife. But I'm so honored that you're on the program. I'm so honored that you're here. We have a time when all of our guests take time and just pray for those that are watching. And we know hundreds of thousands of people watch on a daily basis. And out of those, there are people that are in need. And they need not only the touch of the Lord in their lives, but this strength. There is a fear. I think you touched upon it. There's a fear that we shouldn't have. We should have. The disciples in that book of Acts went out and it says, it describes them as bold. Boldness.
Yeah.
That word boldness is there over and over again. And I think there's many that are in fear, anxiety, there are the pressures of life, you know, it's the cares of life, that just need the instillment of the Holy Spirit for their boldness and their strength in these days. And we just pray that someone just receives that today. And instead of being, you know, you also talk about, I don't know how much time I have left, but you talked about not letting them come to you, but going out in mission. It's the same when it comes to the enemy's attack on our lives. Instead of allowing it to come to us, the Bible says the gates of hell shall not prevail against
us.
We should be on the offense, not always on the defense.
Yeah, nobody's ever been attacked by a gate.
Right. That's right.
We are God's hostage rescue team.
Yeah.
And
come
the
on.
Gates of hell are what stand between us and the people God wants to set free.
Come on.
And they are not going to stand up against the church.
Yes, sir. Yes, that is so good. You are a good Pentecostal preacher for a Presbyterian, brother. I love it. And I know you all are not the average Presbyterian church either. It's just you hold to those values, of course, but you do so many great, great things. It sounds like the Presbyterians don't, but I'm saying that I love your ministry because it breaks some of the paradigms that sometimes religion puts on us, and you're just into all the world with all the gospel. Would you pray with somebody right now that they would have some courage today?
Father God, I pray that you would be pouring your Spirit out on our listeners.
Yes, Lord.
I pray that those who are a little bit afraid would be emboldened. When the disciples were threatened with death, they came to you in prayer and then with joy went out and proclaimed you despite the threats.
Thank you.
I pray, God, that we will do the same, that despite the fear that was generated by the recent shootings, that despite the fear of being rejected in this culture, that we would shine with your light, that
yes.
we would boldly, gently, and graciously speak of your truth. And I pray, Lord, that you would put on each of our hearts someone that we can talk to today. Someone that needs to hear about your grace, about your love, and that you would send us to them and maybe even allow us to be part of a miracle in their life.
Yes.
So that they would know how much you love them.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Before Bethany sings, how about 2 Thessalonians again? This is chapter 2, verse 16. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and our Lord God and Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting consolation,
And Good Hope by Grace comfort your hearts and establish you in every good work and word. Good word and work. Thank you, Pastor. You are welcome here anytime. Let us know what's happening in the church and anything we do to promote. And your services are when?
10:30 Sunday morning.
10:30 Sunday morning. So you're at home and or you're at home. If you're on the road, you're visiting Branson, First Presbyterian is open 10:30 on Sunday mornings. Come see a great man of God and a great church in our community. And Bethany's going to sing for us one more time, and the perfect song, Satisfied. Put your hands together for Bethany Cotter.
Well, you ask me if I'm happy, if I have peace within, if I'm worrying about tomorrow. At rest, then you know I'm satisfied. When my friends they all forsake me and they turn me from their door and they sow no seeds of kindness, make the thorns in my side, I'm gonna sit down by my Jesus, satisfied, well, satisfied, I'm satisfied, satisfied, no trouble can ever get me down, when my eyes close in death, with my Jesus I'll be at rest, then you know I'm satisfied. I got that old time religion, got that old time religion. That is why I'm satisfied. Thank you.
Thank you, Bethany. Wow, great singing. What keeps us going is your support, and we just pray that you would help us. Please, our number one support is you can pray for us, and we'd like you to pray for us because we know that prayer changes things, prayer changes people, and people change things. We know that's what Oswald Chambers said, one of my heroes. But I believe that if we will pray, then we can see a change in our nation. But if you pray for our ministry, it will help us to grow and reach out to many more outlets. We have a lot of ways that we can grow. You know that our ministry not only does the television and the internet ministry, but we also go out on the weekends and we're preaching in churches and singing. I'm singing out there. Also, we're going to places to show where the church really shines in time of need. We've been to where Hurricane Harvey was in Houston. We've been down in the Keys. Just that program is, you just saw. And so we are trying to just be Jesus. We're trying to be missional. I like that. We're going out and not, you know, tell people can come here to the studio, Branson Mill. We love it. But we're going out, as Jesus said to do, go ye therefore. That's King James. Is go is obvious. Ye is y'all. That's King James for y'all. And therefore, you need to figure out what it's there for. So he says, go y'all and do what? What is it there for? And preach to all nations, go and tell the people the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's what we're trying to do. I'm an evangelist through and through. And Paul told Timothy, do the work of an evangelist. And so help support my habit of being an evangelist. Would you do that? And as you do that, our monthly supporters that will give $34 a month, because I've been in ministry 34 years, even though I don't look a day over 35. Trust me, I am. And 34... they laugh. Every time people laugh, nobody says amen. But 34 years I've been in ministry, so that's why we came up with the number. $34 a month will help us. And if we can get thousands of people to do that, we won't have to do commercials. You're about to see a commercial, but does anybody really like commercials? No, do you just like, can't wait to see the commercials on my favorite program? No. So we want to do the commercials, but that will take everybody working together as we should in the body of Christ. This month, though, we send you free gifts if you'll sign up for $34 a month. And this month, if you sign up, we'll send to you free of charge, no shipping. And we never charge for shipping in anything you order from us. But we have a new Christmas CD with Jordan Kyle Band doing this, some of your favorites and some originals for Christmas. This is all going out before Thanksgiving. You'll receive this. Some of you have already received it by the time you watch this program. And then my new coffee stained, I got it in coffee, but it comes in similar deal. And this is my newest on the road DVD, a sermon I preach called Why Would Jesus Touch Somebody a Second Time? He can do it in the first touch, right? Does anybody believe that? Why in some cases did he touch somebody a second time? I can't tell you. You have to get the DVD. So sign up today and become a family of friends. That's what some ministries call partners. We call them our family of friends. Be a family of friends partner today. My wife fell. She falls once in a while. I don't know why, but she can be in a straight parking lot and she'll trip and fall. But this time it was not really her fault. It was in a grassy area. She fell. Anyway, so her back was hurting. She had muscle cramps from working and falling at Silver Dollar City, where she had all her single moms come out there for single Silver Dollar City. And she says, tell people the Neo Relief really works. And so we have this supplement, all natural gel, a balm that squirts out of this bottle. You just take the cap off, you squirt this on, you don't rub it in, you just rub it on the area. And she said within 20 minutes, all of her back and leg pain was gone. So it's just amazing, some of the products. And let me tell you, I've just got a few seconds. Christmas is coming up, right? I know, is it too early to talk about Christmas? I mean, it's Thanksgiving week. So you're about to have big turkey and all, and then we launch into Christmas time. But have you done all your Christmas shopping? I'm telling you, one-stop shopping. Go to kevinshorey.com or call us at 844-47-KEVIN. But if you go to kevinshorey.com, you'll see all the different products, including this one, which is one of our best sellers. You know, we love to give this gift as a thank you for your gift of $50 or more. This is our bottle of silver. And here's the man that helped us put it together, Dr. Pedersen, to talk about sacred, structured silver. Roll it.
Hello, my name is Dr. Gordon Pedersen. My mission is to help lift people physically, spiritually, and mentally. I believe the body will heal itself if you give it the proper tools.
Dr. Pedersen is board certified in anti-aging and regenerative medicine. He has 4 medical doctorate degrees in areas of clinical, research, naturopathic, and wound care. He has worked under Jonas Salk, the American medical researcher noted for the discovery of the polio vaccine. Dr. Pedersen is the medical director of the Silver Health Institute.
I want you to recognize the history of silver. It's part of our mission statement to recognize that 1,000 years ago, silver was nothing more than a coin thrown into a barrel to inhibit bacterial growth. 100 years ago, the new ionic forms and colloids were starting to show up, and they got a lot of really good benefits, medically speaking. Then in the last 10 years, there has been new Aquasil technology, and even patents have been developed throughout this time period. But now, at the Silver Health Institute, we're identifying new and improved forms of silver. Not just Aquasols, not just colloids or ionics, but actual structured silver with benefits like alkalinity, so that your body can use it every single day. As you can see, I'm proud to help research and deliver the new and improved message of the new and improved silver. In fact, these silvers are being studied at the pharmaceutical levels. A pharmaceutical company called Nelson Labs has tested them and found that the new and improved structural alkaline silver outperforms all the rest. This is significant because it's a silver designed for your body to be used every single day.
Thank you, Dr. Pedersen. I'm on my soapbox. I've got a few more new soapbox signs. You see some of the new soap stuff. If you got any soap wrappers or soap detergent boxes that are empty, send them our way. You can have a part in our set background. But this is my soapbox, and I want to get on the soapbox. You know, what we want to do is what the pastor was talking about. And I pray that you'll pray for First Presbyterian Church. You'll pray for Branson. You'll pray for America. And you do your part. I think President Bush, the first President Bush, George H.W. Bush, wasn't too far off when he talked about the 1,000 points of light. There is light that God, just as he set lights in the heavens that we talked about Genesis 1:15 earlier, he has set lights. You are a light to shine for the Lord Jesus Christ. So I'm joining again. 2 Thessalonians 3:1 says, finally, brethren and sistren, pray for us. Let's pray for one another that the word of the Lord may run swiftly and be glorified just as it was given to you and me. So let's go ye therefore and teach the world. Jesus is the answer for our world today. We'll see you tomorrow with Pastor Monty Dunn.
Attention! Are you looking for a product to help with your aches and pains? Are you looking for a product that actually works? Well, we have that product, and it's called Neo Relief. Using all natural ingredients, Neo Relief provides immediate relief to headaches, stiffness of joints and muscles, arthritis, inflammation, backaches, sprains, strains, bumps, and bruises. For only $25 or $3 for $60, you too can own Neo Relief. And as a bonus, we're offering free shipping. Just apply a small amount of gel on your pain and rub it on. Don't rub it in. Just let a thin layer soak into your skin. There are zero side effects and over 100 applications per bottle. For more information or if you'd like to place an order, call 844-47-KEVIN. Or visit us online at kevinshorey.com. You too can own Neo Relief today.
The world-famous Branson Mill at 3300 North Gretna Road, where art meets entertainment, featuring the Corner Store Studio, friendly staff, hundreds of shops, demonstrations, crafts, snacks, classes, artwork, fun for all ages, the Treehouse Cafe. All under one roof at the world-famous Branson Mill, where art meets entertainment.
Guests of the Kevin Shorey Show stay at the Platinum Award-winning Comfort Inn at Thousand Hills, which overlooks the Thousand Hills Golf Course in Branson and features a unique Mountain Lodge theme. The guest rooms are spectacular. Enjoy a free hot breakfast every day. Cool off in the refreshing indoor pool and hot tub. For more information or reservations, call 1-877-335-4727.
Promotional consideration paid for by Meyer Hotels. The preceding program was brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.